Friends, nice morning to all of you. This is Sugan Chaudhary and today we will do textual exercise of our chapter 14, the School for Sympathy. As we have done in our last two parts of the line-to-line explanation of the chapter and textual question answers. So students, let's start our grammar part. Question number first is, read the following dialogues, complete the report that follows. यहाँ पे आपको sentences दे रखे हैं and you have to convert it into reported speech. Okay? So first is, teacher, have you anything to say for yourself? Student, no madam, I have already said everything. यहाँ पे ही conversation दे रखी है between teacher and a student. Okay? Next is, get ready to face punishment for your mistake then. Student, I have no doubt that you will do justice to me. So the teacher asks student, first कहता है, have you anything to say for yourself? कि क्या आप, क्या तुम्हें तुम्हारे लिए कुछ कहना है? तो हम इसे past में convert कर देंगे. The teacher asks student, have you anything था student? So यहाँ पे किस में convert हो जाएगा? ये हमारा past perfect में. So if he had anything to say for himself. The next is, student said, no ma'am, I have already said everything. Then क्या किस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा वो? The student said respectfully, nothing madam. Okay? And added, he had already said everything. Have वाली चीज किस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगी? Had में. Next is, get ready to face punishment for your mistake then. कि अपनी punishment लेने के लिए तुम बिल्कुल तैयार हो जाओ. Then the teacher ordered. उन्होंने order दिया, तो यहाँ पे क्या आ जाएगा? The teacher ordered him to get ready to face punishment for his mistakes. Okay? As आपको भी पता है, यहाँ पे हम son वाला जो rule है, हम उसको follow करते हैं. Okay? Next is, student, I have no doubt that you will do justice to me. Then the student replied that he had no doubt that she would do justice to him. Okay? Next is question number second. Report the following dialogue in indirect form of narration. So, Miss Beam, where are you going? इसका आंसर क्या आ जाएगा? Miss Beam asked the writer where he was going. यहाँ पे आपको direct speech को indirect form में convert करना है. Next is, the writer to visit your school. The writer replied. Writer ने आंसर दिया तो क्या हो जाएगा? Replied. And जब question पूछना हो तब क्या हो जाएगा? Asked. Then the writer replied that he was going to visit her school. Okay. Next is, Miss Beam, why do you want to go in my school? कि तुम मेरे स्कूल में क्यों आना चाहते हो? Then Miss Beam asked the writer why he wanted to go in her school. The writer to see the students who are deaf, dumb and blind. The writer replied that he wanted to see the students who were deaf, dumb and blind. Okay, so I hope आपको ये समझ में आया होगा students. Next is our vocab portion. English is an international language. In it, a word has many forms. A word can be used as a noun, verb, adverb and adjective. So complete the following table. जैसे कि noun, verb, adjective and adverb, ये सब के सब किससे बने हैं? एक noun से बने हैं. For example, like beauty. Verb की form में इसे कैसे define करेंगे? Beautify. In adjective, यानी किसी चीज़ की जब कोई quality बताते हैं, that is adjective. So, beautiful. And adverb, that is beautifully. So, हमें इस तरह से convert करना है following words को. Pleasure. Pleasure, verb, please. Adjective, pleasant. Adverb, pleasantly. Information. Verb is inform. Adjective, informative. And adverb, informatively. Expression. Verb is express. Adjective is expressive. Like she is very expressive. उसकी विशेषता है. Then adverb is expressively. Next is explosion. Verb is explode. Explosive and explosively. Courage. Encourage. Courageous and courageously. Wondrous, wonder, wonderful and wonderfully. So students, इस तरह से हमारा ये हो जाएगा. Okay, now is your writing section. Prepare a speech for your morning assembly on the topic, the real aim of schools, teach the pupils to serve humanity and be good citizens. So students, you have to do this question by your own. Okay, next is a reading test. So as we have given the passage here, this is called reading comprehension. And as you have read this chapter, so this is the questions, the following questions are on the basis of the given passage. But in higher classes, you will solve the questions by having unseen passage. Okay. So Miss Bim laughed. Oh no, she said. She is not lame really. She is only her lame day. Nor all those others blind. It is only their blind day. I must have looked very much astonished, for she laughed again. Then you have an essential part of our system in a nutshell. In order to get these young minds to appreciate and understand misfortune, we make them share in misfortune too. In the course of the term, every child has one blind day, one lame day, one deaf day, and one dumb day. During the blind day, their eyes are bandaged, and it is a point of honor not to pee. The bandage is put on overnight, they wake up blind. This means that they need assistance in everything, and other children are told to help them and lead them about. It is educative to both of them, the blind and the helpers. So, on the basis of your reading, answer the following questions. First is name the chapter and its writer. So, the name of the chapter is The School for Sympathy and written by E.V. Lucas. Next is, why did Miss Bim laugh? Miss Bim laughed because the writer took her student really lame. Okay, मतलब जो उन्होंने अपने students को lame समझा था. That's why Miss Bim laughed. What did Miss Bim do to make young minds understand misfortunes? She made her students share in misfortunes. How are they made blind on blind day? So as it is given in the passage, during the blind day, their eyes are bandaged, and it is point of honor not to peep. The bandage is put on overnight, they wake up blind. So, यहाँ तक हम इसे लिखेंगे. Next is, how it is educative to both of them, the blind and the helpers. The blind need assistance in everything order. Other children are told to help them about, so it is educative for both in blind and the helper, as we have already done the same thing in our question answers also. Next is, pick out the words from the passage similar in meaning. Brief and clear का मतलब क्या होता है? It means appreciate and understand, appropriate and understand. Next is surprise, that is astonished. मतलब एकदम से हैरान रह जाना, shocked रह जाना, that is surprised. So students, I hope you have done this chapter in a very nice way. One second students, it is not appreciate, it is appropriate. Appropriate, यानी कि बिल्कुल clear. Appropriate, okay? It is not appreciate. Okay. So students, if you have still you have any doubt or any query, then you can directly comment in the comment section. And have a beautiful day. Thank you very much.